Going on, guys, welcome back to the channel. Well, welcome if it's your first time here. Well, guys, it is a beautiful day here in East Tennessee. Beautiful weather, just about perfect. You can see I'm here in my short sleeves on. Wonderful weather. It's been that way for the past couple of weeks here. However, as they say about this area, if you don't like the weather, stick around for a couple of days because it's going to change. And it's supposed to start in raining this afternoon, and then next week it's supposed to be a whole lot cooler. Some highs were in the 40s I saw, and the lows were in the low 20s, and that is going to be cold to me in the low 20s. I don't like cold weather, and that's why I live here in East Tennessee instead of somewhere like Montana or Idaho, because of the weather. I do not like cold weather. I do not like being frozen. I do not like going outside and my face and hands being in pain because it's so cold. But anyway, you know, they say that there is two things you should never talk about in public, and that is politics and religion, because someone always gets their feelings hurt and it always causes arguments. And if you noticed on my channel here, I tend to talk about both topics depending on what's going on in the world, and I don't shy away from how I feel, my beliefs. However, you know, every time that I mention anything about politics or religion, the emails come, the hate mail comes, the mean, hateful comments come. And the one I see most often, and the one I think is the most hilarious, are when people emails me to tell me that if I don't do this, if I don't do that, they're going to leave. Okay. Go ahead and leave. If you don't like the content, go ahead and leave. But they expect me, because they don't like the message I'm giving, they expect me to completely change my beliefs, completely change my way of thinking, my thought process, my beliefs, whatever, and change that, my personal beliefs in my channel, to match what they want, to match their beliefs, to match their lifestyle choices or whatever. They think they are so important, people do, that I should completely change my whole philosophy on life, my philosophy on politics, what I think, how I feel, my religion, everything, because they don't like it. And they think I should change it around to match what they like, because they have to be correct. And I've gotten several of these over the last couple of days because I've talked about the election. And I tell you what, if you mention anything whatsoever negative about Donald Trump, people go off the freaking deep end. You can say good things about Donald Trump for a month, about how he was better for the economy, how gas prices was a lot cheaper, how we had it better under Donald Trump because of the economy. He was better at foreign relations, apparently, than Biden is. Biden can't carry a conversation. So Biden isn't worth 2 cents rubbing together. He is useless as a tits on a boar hog, as the saying goes. But Donald Trump wasn't perfect. He had things I didn't like kissing Hillary's ass, like saying that Henry Kissinger was his mentor. He loved Henry Kissinger, looked up to Henry Kissinger. Going to the World Economic Forum meetings, the red flag laws, the bump stock bans, him wanting to ban what he called assault rifles in his book from, I think it was 2020, the book was published. So he definitely isn't perfect. But overall, he was pretty decent. I'm not saying he wasn't. He was good for the economy and good for foreign relations. However, you know, if you say anything negative whatsoever, golly gee whiz, people go the frig off, it seems. You get these big long emails, and I think that people would actually kill me, some of these people would, for speaking ill of the Donald. It's like some religions, I'm not going to name the religion here on this channel, but some religions, if you speak badly against some of their prophets, it's in their religion to kill you, pretty much, as far as I know. We saw that happen before in France, I think it was. Some of you know what I'm talking about. But people has got this cult mentality. and they see a politician as some living God. And they're not a living God, they're a man just like we are. They have emotions, they have happiness, sadness, ego, whatever, just like everyone else does. They are human. And a wasper just landed on my shirt. Could have been a drone. But anyways, it's like when I talked about the Republicans. If they got in the office, if they had this big red wave that he was talking about, which now we know they didn't, if they did, people had it in their head, they're going to change something. They're going to take the country back and go back to the traditional values we had 60 years ago. And I said, it's not going to happen. We're too far gone. It's too far gone to be fixed. And Republicans are pretty much useless. And when they get power, they do nothing with it. They change nothing. And that makes people go off also, because they want to believe so badly that somebody's going to get in elected office and is going to actually change anything and make their life better and take the country back to where it once was, the values that it once was, the financial stability that it once had, the military power that it once had. And it's not going to happen. It's too far gone. The United States is a dying empire. You need to get off your rear ends, stop thinking about, I know most of you aren't like this, but the few that are, get off your rear ends, stop waiting for a savior to come, political savior, only savior is Jesus Christ. Stop looking for those political saviors, prep, accept reality, closer to God, closer to your family, closer to your community, focus your political efforts locally, and prep like crazy because your life depends on it. Stop falling for this political bullshit that keeps everyone sitting and waiting and doing nothing while they're being enslaved. That is one reason, you know, that the QAnon thing was so popular and everyone fell in to the belief of the QAnon bullshit. And I said that was bullshit from the start. It was a big psyop operated by the CIA, in my opinion. We know it's a psyop, we know it's bullshit, because no one's ever arrested. Nothing ever happened. They were always saying that it's Trump's master plan. Just a couple more days, the arrests are going to start. He's going to arrest Hillary. He's going to arrest everybody. He's going to do this and that and something else. And nothing ever happened. It was always next month, next week. It was always soon it's going to happen. But it never happened. And it never was intended to happen. It was all a psyop to keep everyone sitting, thinking, hoping, reading on the internet, posting comments, and thinking something's going to happen when it never was. It was all to keep you sitting longer, to keep you pacified longer, to keep you doing nothing, and keep you thinking that you had a savior somewhere that you could just take all your cares and give all of your cares to the savior, the politician, politics, the government, and it was going to be fine. You just have to wait a little longer. The rest are going to come. We're going to drain that swamp. And it never happened. And as you see now, and I don't know if it was intentionally, if it's planned that way, or what, on both sides, but as you see now, Donald Trump didn't drain the swamp. The swamp drained him. It may have been a setup. There's so many things going on now, guys, you can't tell what's going on. I mean, he may have been put into office to pacify people for a little bit longer on the right, and to bring this other agenda in we see now. It could have been all planned from the start. I don't know. It's complicated. There's so many psyops going on. There's so much psychological manipulation going on. And these are being done by professionals, by people who are trained and go to school to learn psychology, manipulation, brainwashing techniques to get people to believe, to get people to do what they want them to do. And you'll be actually doing what they want you to do that's actually counterproductive to your own happiness, wealth, and health. You'll be doing what they want you to do that's counterproductive to yourself, thinking that you're doing what they don't want you to do. It's amazing at the psychology that they can use. So if you don't like the message, if you don't like what I say on this channel, if you don't like my beliefs, if you don't like what I say, you can always just leave. There's no need in emailing me and telling me that I need to do this, that, something else. I need to change my beliefs. I need to completely change my channel message. I need to do this, that, or something else. to align with what you believe, or you're going to leave. You're going to stop watching the channel. You're going to unsubscribe. You're going to throw my book in the garbage, whatever. If that's what you want to do, then you know that's fine. There's no need for you to be here if you don't want to be here. If you don't agree with the message and it's not going to, you're not going to change your mind, you're not going to change your way of thinking, then maybe you should go find another channel that's more appropriate to you and your thinking. You know, there's all kinds of prepping channels out there, all kinds of homesteading channels out there. And, you know, on YouTube, they're free to watch. There's some got memberships. You can go to Patreon and pay if you want. But you can find something that you like better than my content. However, I'm not going to change my message. I'm not going to change my political views. I'm not going to change my religious views to match yours. Because, quite frankly, you and your opinion aren't that important to me. Now, I know this message isn't to a small percentage of the people watching this channel. Most people subscribe to this channel, comment, or subscribe to my email newsletter are wonderful. They're great people. And if they don't agree with everything, they don't get hostile. They don't get evil. They don't make threats. They don't want to take my life or talking about a mistake that I see that someone else did or something in politics or something in religion or something like that. Most people who watch this channel and don't subscribe to our great, wonderful people. I'm talking to those assheads that think they're so important that I should change my whole way of life, my whole thinking process, my whole belief system, everything to match theirs. Or if I don't, they're leaving this channel. Anyways, if this video was entertaining, give it a big thumbs up. Thanks for watching. End of Creek More Mighty here, and I'll see you guys next video, hopefully.